Hi, this video gives a very brief introduction to binary decision diagrams, which are a tree-like data structure used to represent Boolean functions. Let's start. A BDD is either the constant function that evaluates either only to true or only to false, or it's something like an if-then-else. You look at the value of a variable and based on that you branch. Let me write what I just said. So L stands for leaf, B stands for branch. The value in a leaf is the value to which the function evaluates. Variables are usually represented as integers, more precisely to positive integers. And then you have two branches, the yes branch and the no branch. The variables, there is usually one invariant enforced on the variable order. There are several others, but those I'll discuss in other videos. The invariant on variable order is that they are in strictly increasing order. So let's write that down. Check variable order. Write a recursive function that checks that everything is strictly bigger than a given constant v. A leaf is okay. But for a branch, we need to assert that the variable index increased, and we need to recursively check the high subbranch and the low subbranch. We start with zero because variables are positive. Let's see if this compiles. Okay. Now, how do we evaluate such a function? Well, To evaluate such a Boolean function, we need to be given a variable assignment. That's a function from variables, which are represented by integers, to Booleans. So, let's call that function that gives us the value of variables a valvar. If the BDD is a leaf with some Boolean in it, then we just return that Boolean. It's a constant. But if it is a branch, then we check the value of the variable, and depending on that, we recurse. In the high branch, or in the low branch. Just for easiness of testing, I'm going to write a short function that turns a list of variables that are supposed to evaluate to true into a function that returns true exactly for those variables. So let's check if this compiles now. It might help to look at the types a little bit. So see, the first argument is a variable assignment, a function that tells us what values do variables take, and the result is a function that evaluates BDDs. While here, from a list of variables, we construct a function from variables to their evaluation. Okay. Now, to build some interesting BDDs, apart from false and true, the ones that are a bit more interesting are the ones that look at one variable and require it to be true or false. Those are called positive occurrences of a variable and negatives of a variable. So to require the variable v to be positive, we branch on it and we return true when only when it is positive. And completely symmetrically, we can require a variable to be negative by swapping the value we return. So this BDD represents the Boolean function v, and this BDD represents the Boolean function not v. It's a Boolean function of one variable. And of course, a Boolean function is different from a constant and it's different from a variable. It is a function. Okay, now to build some a little bit more interesting BDDs, we can lift Boolean operations, so operations on Booleans, to operations on BDDs. For example, you can do a logical AND between Booleans like true and false, but you can also do it between functions and to build another function. So that's what we do now. It takes an operator that acts on constants, on Booleans, and two functions represented as BDDs, and we'll construct another BDD. But first, I know that there's going to be many recursive calls, so I'll introduce a shorthand notation. This is just a shorthand to make what I'm going to write next a little bit easy to see, to parse. It will make it the patterns easier to see. Okay, so what we do is we look at the two BDDs and first I will look at the case when both are leaves, because this will make it clear what I mean by lifting a Boolean operation to BDDs. So in this case, what we do is we simply apply the operator to Booleans. So this binary op function, this function, will do to the constant functions, true and false, the same as the operator does to Booleans, true and false. Okay, now the more interesting situation is when we have two branches. The idea here is that we want to build a BDD that, when evaluated, would give the same result as evaluating the two given BDDs in turn, getting a Boolean out of that, and then performing an operation on their two results. So this should come out. Basically, the property is something like that. We want eval of some variable assignment done on the BDD obtained by combining F1 and F2 to be the same as applying the simple operation on Booleans on the results of evaluating the two BDDs separately. So this is a property that we want to ensure, and this is how we design the algorithm. We think what we need to do in order to preserve this property, and we'll also try to make sure that we preserve this ordering of the variables. So what should we do here? Well, if we think of the two evaluations that work in parallel on F1 and F2, The one that works only on the result is going to see only one variable, and the variable that it sees first should be the smallest one. Right, so we evaluate the two BDDs F1 and F2 in parallel, but when one gets to variable 10 and the other one is at variable 3, it waits for the one at variable 3 until it catches up and it gets to the same variable 10. And then when they both look at the same variable, they will both evolve in sync. But if one of them then only cares about variable 20, but the other one cares only about also about variable 15, then the one that cares about variable 20 will wait until the other one catches up. Or another point of view is that we now build a BDD and we can look at only one variable. So now we have to build a branch, and we have to put here to fill in a variable, a high branch and a low branch. What's the variable we're gonna look at? Well, obviously both variable v1 and v2 are relevant, but we can only look at one. And in order to preserve the invariant with variable ordering, we should look at the smallest one. So we'll have a few cases depending on which one is smaller. If v1 is smaller, then we just look at v1 and we descend in the left BDD and recursively apply this binary operation. The other case is, of course, completely symmetric. We just need to change, well, maybe it's clear if I just, it's completely symmetric, but now we look at variable 2 and we descend in the second BDD. Finally, we have the case when the two variables must be equal. And in this case, it does not matter to which variable we look, and we descend in both BDDs. And of course, it might be the case that one is a branch and the other is a leaf. Those cases are going to be very similar to these two, because a leaf is like saying, I finished with all the variables, so if you, the other evaluation, still have something to do, I'm going to wait for you. So here, let's say if the second one is a leaf, then that's morally the same as saying that variable 2 is higher. And we need to do the same as we're doing in this case. And symmetrically, if the first one is a leaf, that's morally the same as saying that v1 is higher, and we need to do the same as in this case. Okay, let's see if this compiles, because they wrote a lot of code. Yes, and let's test a little bit. Good. So I'll build a small BDD that corresponds to variable 1 exclusive or variable 2. To do that, I lift the binary operation XOR to two BDDs. One says variable 1, the other says variable 2. So here's the BDD for exclusive OR. So let's evaluate it to see that it is indeed exclusive OR. For that, we say eval, and first we start with both variables being false, so no variable is true, and we evaluate the BDD that we built earlier. It evaluates to false as it should. Now if we set one of the variables true, the result is true. If we set both variables to true, the result is false. So this BDD that we call x here is indeed representing the Boolean function exclusive OR between the variables 1 and 2. Now let's try something else. Let's do an exclusive OR between several BDDs. So to do that, we fold the operation that does exclusive OR between BDDs. We start with the BDD for false, let's say, and we go over the BDDs representing several variables, several positive occurrences of variables, for example 1 and 2. This should give us the same BDD as before, but we can easily say do it for more variables, say 5. So what we see here is that we got a pretty big BDD, and clearly it might have some redundancy. Let's check if that's the case. So we can compute further the exclusive OR of two Y's. When you do exclusive OR between two identical functions, the result should be the constant function false. Let's see what we get. Well, we get something which is the constant function false because all the leaves are false, but the data structure is quite big. So here's the first thing that you might want to think about, the first question. How to get rid of this inefficiency, of this space inefficiency? The other question would be whether there is some other inefficiency here, maybe time related rather than this. So the first problem would be how to optimize this, how to make sure data structures like this are never produced. So in a way, how to normalize these data structures. Another question you might want to think about would be how to implement these n-ary binary operations. So how to lift n-ary binary operations. Here I just said, well, we apply the binary, we lift the binary Boolean operation to be binary BDD operation, to be a binary BDD operation, and then we repeatedly apply that, so we repeatedly apply that binary BDD operation. But is it possible to do better, maybe by directly lifting an n-ary Boolean operation to an n-ary BDD operation? Okay, so that was all.